अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज मिसेस खान फ्रॉम एमएम मॉडल स्कूल एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच लेसन नंबर 14 टू स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 8A एंड 8B. द नेम ऑफ द स्टोरी इज द मंकी स्पो. इट इज अ वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग स्टोरी. आई होप यू विल एंजॉय इट एंड प्लीज लिसन टू माई एक्सप्लेनेशन क्लियरली एंड टेक योर टाइम, लिसन थॉरली एंड यू विल फाइंड इट इंटरेस्टिंग. लेट अस बिगिन. Without the night was cold and wet. But in a small parlor of laburnum villa, the blinds were drawn. Blind means curtain over here. Were drawn and fire burned brightly. Father and son was at chess. The former, that is the father, who possessed the ideas about the game involving the radical changes, putting his king into a sharp and unnecessary peril that it even provoked comment from the white-haired old lady knitting. Placidly by the fire. So it was the night was cold and wet, and in the room at the Laburnum Villa, the curtains were drawn, and three of them were sitting there. The father, son were playing chess, and the father was giving some ideas about the changes of the rules of the chess. And his king in chess, I hope you all know king hai, minister hai, there are elephants, soldiers, etc. So there were sharp pedals. Pedals means the other side, one could attack, someone to attack. Okay, that is they were against each other. And there are 10 soldiers in front, and small ones, eight soldiers, I think. And they were playing chess, and this way, we can attack the king directly, we can attack the minister, and so on. You have to rules, have to know the rules. And the lady was giving comment. Was sitting, and there was a fireplace also. Hark at the wind, said Mr. White, who having seen a fatal mistake after it was too late, was amiably desirous of preventing his son from seeing it. So when we make some mistake while playing chess, maybe while playing Ludo, and we don't want our opposition to see it, what we say, we have to divert their mind. So to divert their mind, Mr. White, what did he say? Hark, look at the wind. And he had given while playing the chess. So he wanted to deprive the son from seeing that mistake. I am listening, said the latter, that is the son, stretching out his hand. Check. So when we make mistake in chess, the word check is used, checkmate. I should hardly think that he'd come tonight. So the father said that maybe I think that tonight it's raining, it's wet, it's cold. I hardly think that he would come. Maybe some guest was to arrive, with his hand poised over the board. He kept the hand over the chessboard. Mate, replied the son. I told you, no? Checkmate. We use the word checkmate. Mane, he had made some mistake. His father had made some mistake. That's the worst of living so far out, bawled Mr. White. Mr. White, what did he say? We are living so far that is the worst thing. Of all the beastly, slushy, out of the way places to live in, this is the worst. This place is not the proper place to live in, where we are living. The road is torrent, meaning it's totally, it's empty types. I don't know what people are thinking about. I suppose because only two houses in the road are let, they think it doesn't matter. So only two houses on the road were having some people in it. To let means, are let means, people are living in those houses, maybe by on rent, maybe their own, but only two houses were on the road. "Never mind, dear," said his wife, soothingly. "Perhaps you will win the next one. So you are changing the topic. This time you haven't won from your son that chess game. So maybe next time you will win." Mr. White looked up sharply. This time he got annoyed. Just in time to intercept a knowing glance between mother and sons. What he wanted to say something, but at the same time, what happened? The mother and son, they were looking at each other. The words died away on his lips, and he hid a guilty grin in his thin gray beard. And he was feeling guilty. "There he is," said Herbert White, as heavy footsteps came towards the road. Herbert could hear the footsteps towards the door. So he said that, "There he is, the guest has come." The old man rose with hospitable haste. They fast quite quickly. Hospitable means to receive someone warmly. It is called hospitable. And he got up quickly, opening the door. Was heard condoling with the new arrival. He was condoling the new arrival, the new person who had come. Mrs. White coughed gently as her husband entered the room, followed by a tall, burly head, beady of eye, and rubicund of visage. So, a very tall man with beady type of eyes, and big eyes, and a burly man means a very active types man, but he was old. And rubicund of visage, it shows that he was an old man, not a quite young one. "Sergeant Major Morris," he said, introducing himself. What did he say? Who had come? The guest, Sergeant Major Morris. The Sergeant Major shook the hands and taking the proffered seat by the fire. Where did he sit? By the fire, because it was quite wet and cold outside. Watched contentedly while his host got out whiskey and tumblers. Host means Mr. White. He went and got what? The whiskey and the tumblers. Money where he would give the whiskey for to the guest for drinking. And stood a small copper kettle on the fire. There was also a copper kettle on the fire. At the third glass, money two glasses they had whiskey already. And at the third glass, he began to talk. There was a little family circle. Regarding the eager interest, this visitor from a distant parts, as he spoke of wild scenes of wars and plagues and strange people. So Major Sergeant Morris, he was a major. So he had been going to very many places, visiting many places, being the head of the soldier, and that also a major. And he was talking about many wild scenes of wars, what he had maybe he had faced or maybe he had taken part in the wars, plagues, different type of what to say now, what we are having, COVID-19, it's a type of a plague only, and strange people. 21 years of it, he had been working for 21 years, nodding at his wife and son. So Mr. White said it was 21 years of it. When he went away, he was youth in the warehouse. When he had gone for working, he was a youth. He was a young person. Now look at him. "I'd like to go to India myself, just to look round a bit, you know." So he also wanted to go to India. And that means that Major Morris had come to India, had visited India. So the Mr. White is saying that I also want to go to India myself. "Better where you are," said the Sergeant Major. What he said? That better be where you are. You don't have to go to India. "I should like to see those temples. India is famous for its temples, fakirs and jugglers," said the old man. "What was that you started telling me the other day about the monkey's paw or something, Morris?" He was saying that Mr. White said that the other day Major Morris had told him about something about the monkey's paw. And what is India famous for? According to Mr. White, India is famous for the temples, fakirs and jugglers. Nothing, said the soldier hastily. Quite quickly, the soldier, Major Morris, said that nothing. Monkey's paw? Mrs. White was very curious to know. Well, it's just a bit of magic. It's a magic, perhaps. Major Morris said that maybe it is something. He was not very, he did not give so much importance. Very casually, he said that maybe it was a bit magic. His three listeners leaned forward eagerly. All three leaned forward eagerly. To look at, said Sergeant Major, is just an ordinary little paw dried into a mummy. So it is just an ordinary paw of a monkey, and it has been dried, and when it was dried, it became a mummy.